So you started making your own PCBs at home? Maybe you're doing only one at a time, maybe 10 or even 20. Or maybe you started your own T&D store to sell your great ideas. No matter what, at one point you'll end up having such a box full of components. And the workflow's just terrible. You finally found that 10k ohms resistor, put it right back into the bag, or you'll end up having unlabeled components all over the place. And that drove me crazy, so I came up with this. These are the magazines. You label them, fill them up and store them in your shelf. When you're starting a small production run, simply grab the components you need and click them onto the rail. I even color-coded them, so capacitors are blue, resistors are black and ICs, diodes, etc. are in gray. Finding components and picking and placing them is a breeze, and you will be rushing through your PCBs in no time. The original idea to store SMD strips like that came from Max Int. I found this on Thingiverse and it immediately caught my attention. Although I found this to be a very nice design, I kinda had a few modifications in my mind. So I booted up Fusion 360 and designed my own variant. I knew that I might want to store larger components, so I made it a bit bigger. Also, I wanted that little plastic covering to be redirected backwards so it does not interfere when picking components. I went through a couple of design iterations and played around with the overall shape, size and thickness. A few prototypes later, I was happy with how it peeled the tape. It seemed to pick up the plastic covering just fine, and also you are able to advance the tape with one hand. Great, actually that's a pretty usable device already. But I figured it might be mandatory to kinda mount this to the desk so things don't fall over all the time. So I printed another version with a clamping lever. It's spring-loaded and pivoting around the screw. And while assembling, I printed a prototype of the mounting rail to test the fit and overall feel of how these two attach. The layer of foam is there to give it some back pressure against the rail. This adds rigidity and also makes it feel a whole lot nicer. There is a fair amount of slack, and that is by design. It's necessary to accommodate for 3D printing tolerances, but more important, it's there so you can easily engage both parts without having to fiddle around. You just kinda push it in there and it guides itself in place. My design felt quite right, and I could not resist in getting forward with this project. So I started producing a whole bunch in different colors. Besides color coding according to the component type, you might also want to note other things like its value, voltage or other useful infos. I chose to go with the standard label printer. But there is a problem. The label will not stick to the surface of the 3D printed parts. I even tried reinforcing the label with some sticky tape. But it will still peel off after a short amount of time. Why is that so? Let's take a look under a microscope. This is a close-up of a 3D printed surface where you can clearly see the layers. The problem is that the roundness of the layers basically leave no surface area for the sticky tape to grab onto. In fact, let me show you. Here's that part where you can see the tape and the layers. Doesn't look like a strong bond, doesn't it? My first attempt to fix this was sanding. I took some 240 grit sandpaper and gave it a few swipes. Although the labels did stick pretty good, the surface didn't look very good at all. So I tried something else. My second attempt was to apply some acetone to the parts. I know what you're thinking. Acetone's actually used on ABS rather than PLA like in my case, but it still has an effect. It seems to have flattened the surface a bit, and also the part feels a bit sticky and not so glossy anymore. But as you can see, the PLA starts degrading, and after a couple of days, the tape eventually loses contact again. So it took yet another approach to figure things out. I bought a water-based clear coating and applied that to the part. Then I added a second layer after 30 minutes of drying, and then let that part cure overnight. And now you can see how the coating has filled the gaps and smoothened out the layers, leaving a much better surface. It's not perfect, but it's a lot better. The printed label sticks pretty well, and that's good enough for me. If you have a different approach to this, please leave a comment. I'm curious to know. Let's finally tackle the last piece, which is the mounting rail. I made these steel pieces and painted them to keep things nice and clean. Although this step is not strictly necessary, I highly recommend adding some weight to give the entire setup some rigidity. If you do not have the tools to prepare a piece of steel like that, you could simply glue in some spare washers, nuts, or basically anything you have on hand. Next, I took some 10mm foam I salvaged from a delivered parcel, marked it and cut it to size. After securing it with a little bit of hot glue, I added some felt pads so it sits on the bench even nicer. Now you wanna get started and make these for yourself? I have detailed instructions on Thingiverse on how to do so. Everything is free for you to download. I even included multiple STL files to cover most common SMT strip dimensions. But if you need a special size, simply open the Fusion 360 project and tweak the user parameters yourself. You'll find everything you need in the video description. These magazines might not be for everyone. Sure, it takes some time to print all of these, but if you ask me, it's just a great addition to the shop. If you built them for yourself, I'd be more than happy to see them on Twitter. I hope you liked the video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up.